Hello there everyone and welcome to a video that is coming out on the day that a game is coming out. It's amazing because I actually got this the night before it came out. I am of course talking about One Piece Pirate Warriors 3, or if you're Japanese, it is Kaizuku Musou 3. It is a game I've been really looking forward to, and when I found it in my mailbox a day early, well, I just about screamed. Let's get it started. Oh, I see how this is gonna be. Well, I'm just gonna finish my sentence and then I'll cut ahead. Basically, I was super excited for this game. Pirate Warriors 2 was one of my favorite games, really, of all time, minus the lackluster story, which this game promised to fix. And I was super excited to find it in my mailbox early. And so this video should be going up, as long as this doesn't take forever, on the day that the game comes out. And, even though I pre-ordered, I have not got my pre-order codes yet for my DLC, which is basically because of the fact that I shouldn't have the game yet. But Canada Post is a funny thing. So let's just wait a sec. I'll get back to you in a moment. And we're back. Oh my god, I was like out of the room when it stopped. So I had to run in. But it's all good. Okay, is my controller off? No, it's totally not. Okay. Create save data. As you can see, this is totally... I've never seen that menu before. I need to go back. This has never popped up on my PS4, and I have around 8 or so PS4 games. That's very surprising, the fact that I have 8 or so PS4 games. But this is also surprising. I've never seen this. This is like the PS3's manual save screen. That's very interesting. As I was saying, never touched this game before. Playing easy to make things easier. I'm going to say easy for now. The only vibration. Of course, I love vibration. Connect to PSN, sure. The only thing easy does is it lowers the enemy health bars. So it's like, whatever. Let's get in a little easy, you know. No big deal. Oh, I love that logo. Omega Force. Ooh, look at all these fancy logos. And gameplay apparently is gameplay recording is stopped, so you can't see this right now, I'm sure. It's not like I've made a way to get around that. Apparently this game's really bad for blocking out a lot of scenes. Out of all the Pirate Warriors press touchpad button. Okay. Out of all the intros, I think that's probably the weakest one. I mean, I still love the music, but... Oh, dude, this has a JoJo-style navigator in the form of Kobe. Hey, Kobe, have you found your dad yet? Jokes about Koban or Mani. Don't skip story events. Interesting, interesting stuff. Data sharing. Share data over PSN. Yo, there's a limited number. Oh, interesting. Oh, so you can this is cross save in its own special way. Very good. Well, we're gonna go through Legend Log. I am guessing that intro was non-canon, considering it was 2 years later. Luffy, Ace, and Sabo. Man, I've seen this intro so many times because of the 4Kids version, which I still stand by is not as bad as people say. I actually love it. The Great Age of Pirates is one of the coolest age names I've ever heard. Man, the Great Age of blank, anything could be cool, but pirates especially. So if you don't know, this game basically covers the entire plot up to, I think, the halfway point of Dressrosa. Now this is interesting because I've never actually watched the beginning in Japanese. I had no idea what Shanks sounded like, and that's not what I would have guessed. Oh no, maybe that's I guess what I thought it would be. Well, expect to see a lot of crying if you're new to One Piece. Expect to see a lot of crying. Little Luffy's cool. Sad he's not a character on his own. Man, I remember seeing this on TV as a kid. It was the best. That I hear a lot, because I've been marathoning One Piece, and every episode ends with that. Oh, that's a lot of text popping up on the screen. Is that just quotes? I guess that is. Prologue, Episode 1, Romance Dawn, not to be confused with the terrible RPG version of this story. Mangiri Luffy set sail from his village to fulfill his promise to the great pirate Red-Haired Shanks, who met when he was a child, and to realize his dream of becoming the Pirate King someday. But no sooner had he set out, his ship was sunk. Cast adrift and at wit's end, Luffy was saved by a boring boy named Kobe, who had been pressed into service on a certain lady pirate's ship. Kobe dreamed of becoming, it's narrating, but you guys can't understand it because it's Japanese, unless you can, in which congratulations. Inspired by Luffy's courage, determination to become the Pirate King, he bravely defied the Lady Pirate. Pleased with his courage, Luffy defeated the Lady Pirate and sets, it's not going to say the Lady Pirate's name, really? Before long, they arrived at Shell's Town, a town ruled by Morgan, captain in the Marines. There, Roronoa Zoro, who in the English version was originally known as Zolo, but then they switched it. And apparently in broadcasts on TV, he has to be known as Zolo, but he's officially Zoro. There's some weird rule with that, where they actually record every line that says his name twice, depending on the version. It's very strange. He was known as a pirate hunter, had been taken prisoner. Luffy had decided that he wanted strong crewmates. Ignoring Kobe's pleas to stop, he headed for the turf of the Marines who had captured Zoro. I'm so mad they still don't have Zoro's iconic costume. The white shirt, it's like, why? Why do they not want to put that costume in this game? It's three games in and it's not even DLC. I really love the more manga style. It's the way the shading looks. You'll especially see in gameplay. I heard a lot of people don't like it, but I definitely do. Man, so much of this got glazed over in the 4Kids version, though. Like, so much. I remember when I first watched this, I thought Kobe would be with them the entire time as the annoying child sidekick, but thankfully I was wrong. Also, this is shortening down what is essentially, I think, like 20 episodes of just talking, so One Piece is pretty bad for that. Also, I don't read the manga, I apologize. I know a lot of people will be like, yo, why don't you read the manga? And it's just because I don't have time. You know, when, even when I'm watching, it's just like I put it on and work. It's a little hard when it's subbed. That's why I like dubbed a lot. Actually, dubbed One Piece, the Funimation one, is very good. I'd recommend that if you wanna get started. I also don't recommend you get started because they're on episodes like 700 something, and I somehow caught up before this game came out. We're gonna get Zoro to join our crew. Can't decide that. I hope the translation in this one is a bit better than the last one because it had some awkward sentences. Gameplay time? Oh yeah, here we go. So Zoro's there. So this is interesting because this level I don't think was in any of the previous games. So bring Zoro into your crew. Defeat conditions, fail to rescue Zoro, defeat the Marines and head to Zoro. Okay, that seems easy enough. Battle prep, we don't have anything. Army info. Just us, a lot of commanders. Check legend. Oh my god, what is this? Legend diary. Complete romance dawn. Clear S, hard difficulty. 600 exclamation marks in a battle. S in romance dawn, get S KO. I don't know what any, well, I mean, I know what this means, but. Okay, interesting. So we got a new type of achievement system, if you will. Treasure events, destroy all, oh, this is straight up Hyrule Warriors style. I actually am looking forward to this. We can learn to play on our own skill poster. We don't have hints. It should explain while we're playing the new stuff. They wouldn't just, you know, they wouldn't just make us go off on our own, right? Oh god, this game looks so much nicer than 2. Oh my god, this frame rate is actually decent. Okay. I am... Oh my god, look how many enemies there are. This is way... Oh, guys, you don't get it. I was just playing Pirate Warriors 2 and saying, like, man, if only this game, like, looked a little better. That's what this is right now. Oh my god. Okay. Enough fangirling over the fact that it looks really good, even though it really does. Let's head up here. And, oh my god, there's so many more enemies than normal. So L2 is now lock on, it seems. That's different. Used to be clicking the stick. Okay. Ah, there's a, T thing. Give us some more SP. I'm gonna go and fight these guys a bit more before. Oh. That's different. Oh my god, is it gonna actually say that gameplay is blocked every time I go into story? Because that's stupid. That's really stupid, honestly. Okay, that's interesting. We got mid-battle story events. If I remember, in the English version, they got him off a cross and just made it a pole. Because apparently, just the shape of a cross was too religious for 4 kids. Let me guess, the sword's gonna be at the entire other end of the map. Oh, Luffy, you just don't listen to anyone. Also, can I? There we go. This game, one thing I love, most of the taunts are just equipping stuff. For Luffy, it's his hat, other characters have other stuff, but we'll get to the best ones after. I'm gonna leave that, since this is like a mid-base thing, in case that's something I want to keep for later. So, as I was saying with in the Let's Look at Pirate Warriors 2, one thing I really love about this game is the fact that unlike, say, the Hyrule Warriors games, the heavy attack button can actually have its own set of heavy attack strings. It's not just a one-off, like you can go heavy, light, light, heavy, or heavy, heavy, heavy. It's not just a one attack thing, which is very nice. Yeah, we're already getting way more KOs than we would in most other games. Now, I should also not worry too much about saving my my meter, if you will. Because it seems to build up pretty quickly. That looks like an attack that should instantly break the slam the foot down. And we found our boss here, Axe Hand Morgan. Oh, it's so weird gonna have to try and... The lock-on button. I mean, I prefer it being on an actual button to being on a, I don't like pressing in sticks. It doesn't feel super reliable for me. I know some people like it, but that's not me. Yeah, our meter builds up really fast. Like, hilariously so. It's in the base's armory. Well, I think this is the armory right here. This definitely looks like an armory. Gate guard has appeared. Nope, guess not. This is just some trophies and probably a lot of references that I don't really get because I haven't watched the intro to One Piece in a long time. Actually, though, because I pre-ordered this on Amazon, I am getting a digital copy of the entire Romance Dawn arc, which would be cool if I had anything to read it on, but I don't. I don't have an iPad. I guess I could do it on my phone. My phone has, like, no room because I fill it with all sorts of music. Okay, so it says break all the treasure chests. I'm guessing the mission to break all the things is getting all the treasure chests. Because it was, you know, defense up. Ooh, these are a lot of chests. Some life up. Ooh, we got the sword. That's cool. Camera. Okay, so let's get this, though. That looks cool. Ooh, money. Some berries. I hope they're not mistranslated in this game. But there's three of them here. Well, Luffy, you're in for a bit of a surprise. Is this door gonna open? No. Oh, this one did, though. Alright. One thing I like... Oh, we have 3 minutes to get there. Okay. One thing I... Ooh. Okay, there we go. Time limit. One thing I love about Luffy is just his speed and ability to just keep running and fighting. It's great. And we can get to him in time, I'm sure. Even with us... Oh my god, there's so many enemies compared to the other ones. Hey, Nami's here. I didn't even know she... Ah, actually, no, she does appear in the first part. Okay. So, camera doesn't seem to be correcting itself as much, it feels. Oh my god, look at all these enemies that are going to get destroyed, though. Wow, so much the 720 on the screen is blinking like crazy. Was this treasure vent? By defeating tough enemies, treasure vents, omen marks. Okay, interesting. Okay, so we'll do that not necessarily right now. We'll see if we can get that after. Do want to defeat the commanders, though, because they can do stuff that can make your life not so fun. Okay, no, let's actually run back there. I think we'll have time. 2 minutes? Yeah. That's cool. See if we can, hopefully we can. I don't know if my secret dashing strategy works in this one. Where is she? Oh, no, it's not her. It's just this marine commander. Oh, treasure event. What's this mean? Oh, no, right here. We're meeting her. You're welcome, Nami. Man, I like her haircut. What's with her? Okay, so I actually really like it. There's a bit of extra stuff. Like, it's not just the levels. It's also going to be quite annoying to make sure I get all the stuff. The map to the Grand Line? Well, that sounds important. She better have it, and then maybe we'll have to have her. Oh, we'll get to Buggy, alright. Was that her outfit in Pirate War? It wasn't. That's a new outfit. It's very revealing and looks nothing like how Nami did at the beginning of... I'm so used to, like, her blue and white striped shirt and also not looking like she's smuggling watermelons in her chest. Like, if you look at how she looked at the beginning, she looked rather normal. Not so much anymore. Yeah, it's so... Oh, did the time limit go up? No, it's still there. It's so weird how they decided to make it so that you can't stream the game during any story cutscenes. It's, I mean, it's not the biggest deal considering I don't do that much. I mostly use my own recording devices for reasons such as that. No, it's a strange choice. Apparently, all the PS4 Warrior games have that issue, which is pretty dumb. I don't like the whole blocking period in terms of having you, you know, stream stuff. I'd much rather someone just, you know, just let me have the full game. It's kind of dumb. I should turn off those notifications. I don't exactly know how. So these are pre-rendered, it looks like. Yeah, definitely. Look really good, though. I'm so happy they're able to recreate the crazy eye bulging faces in super HD CGI. It's wonderful. Get it, devil? Because he ate the devil fruit? That's probably an unintentional pun on his part. Pun intentional. Thank you for just dropping me into the action completely on my own. Okay, whoa, I got a new gauge. That's the Kazuna gauge. As you deal out damage to enemies, the Kazuna gauge will rise. When the gauge is full, your Kazuna level will increase. If Kazuna level 2 or more, press the attack button once more during a charge attack and your crew mem- What does that mean? Charge attack. Yo, wait, what? When I attack after I press the... Oh my god. It's just straight up another attack in my combo. And he has two... Oh my god. This is the coolest way of letting you have... Oh, jeez. You guys see this, right? The fact that I just have... is this unlimited for this, just this part, or... Because it's like it's just giving me another attack at the end of my combos that will seem to possibly be very customizable. I didn't know of this system. Okay, so when your Kazuna level goes up, the power of your Kazuna attack will also increase. Also, Kazuna attacks are different for each character. That is the coolest thing. So yeah, I have to, though, be mashing it, essentially, to get it to work. If I dash, it doesn't seem to. Yeah, like that, see? Okay. That's a lot of KOs, also. And you can then keep going. God, this is such a cool system, actually. It's such a good way to make it look like you're actually fighting together. And then does he stay there? Well, he stays by you. Oh, man. If you can't tell, I just love attacking enemies like this. But I have other attacks, too. I guess I should show off. Well, I don't have many unlocked right now. Get these guys at least. Well, okay, I'm getting trophies everywhere. What was that question mark, though? Oh, it's up there. Let's go up there and get that treasure event. Is it up here? Come on, guys. No, it mustn't be. It must be this in here. Hello? I mean, it looked like someone was there. Am I just... Okay, wrong button. Is there a thing that just shows where it is on here? Like a nice zoom in? No. Huh. I mean, I'm here. It's not letting me, though. That's a little strange. Is it in here? No. Huh. Am I here too early? Did I have to get this too? No, because we got both these. Oh, now there's dudes coming out of here, though. Oh, this is going to be good. That was good. That was what I wanted. Is it the statues? Do we have to break the statues? Because I didn't know you could break them. They also break in one hit. Oh, please. Oh, I was going to say, don't tell me I missed, but I didn't. Oh, 2,000 KOs. That's what I like to see. So where is... Am I supposed to be breaking statues, or... Is it break all the statues? Is that the requirement? Also, this is... Yeah, there we go. Treasure event. That's great. That's actually a very smart, fun thing. Have you gotten made enemies of the Marines? How'd you get messed up? Well, you were with me, Monkey D. Luffy. Calm down, Kobe. Jeez. Just go back to playing some Sonic Runners, bro. Please go watch my Versus video where I did with Kobe. It's a great video. Give it a Google. Google it. It's so funny seeing super animated Luffy versus still image Kobe. Also, his hand is very strange looking. Apparently breaking statues was like exactly what he needed to get his dream. Man, this is nice and all, but what happens later in a, you know, a certain event involving the Marines, possibly in a type of vehicle, like a Ford, if you will. You could almost call it a Marine Ford. I don't know. Is he in that? Because I actually didn't watch that. Like, here's the thing. Most of my knowledge of One Piece comes from playing these games and getting the story from them. I did watch, you know, a couple movie recap things. The only one arc that I know absolutely nothing about is Fishman Island, which is in this game. So I'll get to learn from it in this game. Oh my god, that's actually so sweet. Can we even do it after this? That is hype. This game is hype. I love it. You can even string together combos with it. And that seems like a thing, like some type of Kazuna cancel, you know, that would cost meter. But no. doesn't.
Mission successful.
Ah. Really? Is a boss fight gonna be blocked too? So we got shocked marks. Oh, that tiny cutscene was enough. Okay. Okay. So we got boss fight, same stuff from before. Hit bosses when they're done attacking. What's the guard button? Oh, that's not the guard button. I forgot there's an R1 attack. What's it in this case? It's just a punch. It's just a straight pistol. Nice, okay. I mean, I don't really have to wait for the shock marks, because my punches are just powerful enough. Okay, so they have segmented life bars, though. Oh, and they have the power to go full hockey or whatever. Forget what it's called in this one. Press R2 to do Kazuna Rush. Your normal Kazuna attacks are powered up into devastating chain combos. You can do a special Kazuna attack. Okay, I see where this is going. Okay, so this is a natural evolution of the hockey system and stuff. Oh my god, what is happening? It is glorious. I gotta finish off with the Kazuna though, it said. Come on. Okay, let's do this. That should be enough. Gum Gum Triple Sword. Phoenix of Cannon. Phoenix of Cannon. Guys. Phoenix of Cannon. That's probably a mistranslation, but I don't even care. Hopefully no QTEs like Pirate Warriors 1. Not a big fan of those. Oh, the Pirate Warriors theme is so hype, though, for stuff like this. Wait, did we... Oh, no, I was gonna say, did we hit him backwards from just hype? That's our Zoro! Or Zolo, if you're watching on TV. Morgan's defeat the hands of Luffy. Shell's town was liberated from Morgan's rule. Town served... was saved, not served, because of their actions. But as they were pirates, Luffy and friends were chased out by the Marines. Look at that stupid-looking Marine. Truthfully, we're thankful that you saved the town. However, does not mean we look past you being pirates. See, the Marines are such a... What's the word? What am I looking at? Like the D&D. Like they're heroic neutral? Is that a thing? I could be wrong. I forget how that thing goes. But the thing is, like, no, they're lawful neutral. Frick, I forget how that thing goes. But, like, even though they're the villains of the series, they're well-intentioned from time to time, you know? It's like, they're genuinely, you know, as a courtesy, will not be contacting headquarters. They're villains, but they're also have their own, like, you know, they're willing to look past stuff. We got our first crew member. See ya, Kobe, we're never gonna see you again unless we kill you accidentally when we're fighting one of the many Marines that you normally would. That's fine. Luffy, how dare you reveal his secret past? Yo, that was for sure censored in the North America in 4Kids. They probably switched it out to threw a pie at him or something, squirted him with a water gun. We had a motion cutscene. That's new. Also, Luffy totally just knocked out a kid.
Oh,
true idiot. What a title. Check his lineage? Really? You know, if he had more than one facial expression, this would be a bit more, a bit more emotional. Some monkey business, get it? That's his first name. Or wait, Monkey D. Luffy. Wait, no, that's his last name. Wait, no. Luffy's his first name, yeah. Then is Monkey his family name? I'm not sure. I should know this. It's also very late at night, and we'll be going to bed after this video is done. If I wasn't so tired, I would totally Photoshop him into Big Boss, but I am beyond that point right now. We'll meet again, Kobe. Yeah, about that. To be continued. Yes, I love that symbol. Okay, so you can't get S ranks on easy. Okay, that's fair. Yo, Paramecia, start of a voyage. Is that like my class and current level? Because I'm not like 2 years later, if you will. Okay, so we got square, triangle, triangle. Here we go, Legend Diaries. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, ooh. Okay, so you got Morgan, 10 Morgan coins apparently. Oh, this is all new stuff. During battle, your crew level will go up according to the number of exclamation marks you obtained, which unlike Metal Gear, you want to get them in this game. As your crew level increases, you'll get very, very special bonuses. So is this just like the, oh yeah, this is just, oh my god, there's a lot more coins than normal. This character can now be used from the beginning of battle. The character's skill poster has also been obtained. Zoro's skill poster, Morgan's skill poster. Morgan has a skill poster, I don't think he's playable though. Okay, by completing the requirements of the skill poster, you can learn player skills. This is all new stuff. It's interesting how they're really changing up the system. Oh, and you don't have to pay for the crew gallery stuff now. Okay. Coins. Do you want to automatically set coins? Yes, that's actually such a nice feature. Okay, this is totally different from the last one, because instead of just choosing random ones, you just have to put in ones that are in the game. Okay. So, oh my god, yeah, this is gonna be really nice, actually. That's a good system. That's a great system, actually. Free log is now playable. Online mode is now available. Zoro is now available. Item is in the gallery. Item is in the shop. Yo, we'll always be friends. You have earned a trophy. How many trophies have I already earned, though? That was a lot. Oh my god, it keeps happening. I warned you about the trophies, bro. Okay. Okay, so I see how this is going. They're still going. How many trophies have I got already? I am already at... Where does it say the percent? It doesn't. Look at all these trophies. So what did we get? We got Kazuna, skill poster. So long, thanks for treasure. Obtained one coin. Yeah, they really front-loaded. Defeat 1,000 enemies in a single battle. Unleash 20 more Kazuna attacks in one battle. Okay. Sounds good, guys. I am heading to bed. See you all in the morning when we, well, no. In the morning, this should be up. Maybe. I'm very tired. Tomorrow, I'll be recording more. But don't worry, that means absolutely nothing to you. Thank you all for watching part 1 of One Piece Pirate Warriors, and we'll see you next time when we, go find out who this Buggy the Clown is. Let's go buggy him up, if you know what I'm saying. See you all next time, guys. Ciao.